Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to eetv. We are talking about microbiological dangers. Sometimes we can call, it seems to me we're all living in a hot zone. We're living in a period where we are being attacked first by SARS, okay? You know, then in recent years, in the old days we had influenza, now we have SARS, now we have Ebola. We all know Ebola poses a real threat. In fact, it is out of control. Okay, but it is not that badly out of control. The only real danger is mutation. The mutation rate of Ebola can be quite fast. And sometimes I suspect that is why it comes and goes from the face of Earth. It just disappeared for a number of years and bingo, it comes out again as an indication, possibly, of high mutation. Now, if the mutation is fast enough, there's a possibility of having Ebola evolved to the point it can spread through air, and then we have real trouble on hand. That's my concern. So we cannot treat Ebola as if it is a steady, not changing. It's a changing biological entity. And aside from that, as a citizen of Hong Kong, I'm very concerned as to how the Hong Kong government is going to handle a case like this. Let me pose a story. Let's say we have a European friend and an American friend from Africa or from somewhere. It got contacted with an Ebola patient without knowing it. Maybe we have a carrier on hand. Then the gentleman or the lady flew back to Europe and get in touch with the Hong Kong merchant. And this merchant would unknowingly caught the same disease. All these potential patients carry the bug without knowing it. But within a few days, most likely they will die without effective treatment. Effective treatment at the moment is not available. So there is a finite possibility we'll have a patient who knows from where, and will land in Hong Kong, and we will discover that. I want to know, do the government of Hong Kong have a means, okay, to handle this patient? Let's open up a discussion. It's a can of worms, okay? The way you deal with it is you check the temperature of your patients landing at the Lantau Airport, but the way it is being checked is pretty loose. It's not very tight. As far as I'm concerned, you should treat Ebola as a terrorist. The way to deal with it should be checked within a confined space, and the best confined space in the airplane is the airplane itself. So whenever any plane that fly into Hong Kong, it should be checked, okay, while the airplane is up in the air. Okay, it's total control. Then the government have a chance to react to episodes. And it is highly likely that you'll be able to contain the spreading of disease, and the containment is the vital point. So let me regurgitate. The possibility of mutation, okay, because this happens in Ebola Reston. In the town of Reston, when the Ebola was discovered in monkeys, and it appears that Ebola have been able to spread from cage A to cage F, okay? Now, I forgot the numbers, but it was spread through air. So you may say that this will not happen. I won't say it that way. Accidents are accidents. There's imminent danger. And the only way you can deal with it is containment and control properly. I also want to know whether Hong Kong government have the right equipment and the policy, and as well as compassion treatment. Compassion treatment in the sense that in case we have a hard case at hand, we're not going to fly the patients everywhere. Does the government have the right cocktail of medicine and serum to deal with the bug? So thank you. Just, this is a thought. Thank you very much.